Check it out, folks. You know what it is? It's Fantasy Football Appetizer Friday. Not for real. Check this out. You guys read that title. You know what we're doing. I'm getting ready to show you how to make this beer cheese, you know, dip. Hey, and guess what? We adding bacon. Let's get it. Okay, so look, check this out. I'm using some pecan wood. Look, this that thick cut bacon, right? I'll just put this out here in case you guys want to look at it. Don't forget, the full ingredient list is on my website. That's smokinandgrillinwithab.com. That's WITAB.com, right? So what I'm doing is now, because I'm using a smaller cast iron, right? So I'm going to go ahead and just start lining my bacon up in here, because I did say it got bacon in it, right? Okay, so look, bacon is really done, right? If I pull this back, let me show you guys. I got this. You don't need a whole lot of bacon. It's just really like for just the top, like kind of like a garnish, but we want the flavor too. You guys got to get yourself a splatter guard, you know, if you don't have one already. If you're doing the cleanup, you'll know why. It'll keep all of your, you know, look at that, all that splatter inside, right? So I'm gonna flip these, put this back on top, set this off to the side. Now we're gonna go ahead and cut these, right? So I'm gonna cut them like this because we want to put a little char on them, right? Probably want them to be more like a half inch, you know what I mean? This is what we're gonna use to dip. So when you're watching the game, your friends can just go ahead and grab them with a toothpick, you know the rest, and then we hit them in that cheese dip. Now you guys have been following me for a minute, know that great things start, you know, with the bacon fat, right? So got my, what is this? I got my strainer, fine. I'm gonna go ahead and just pour some of this out right here. You know what I mean? Actually, I'm gonna pour all of it in there. The strainer is to catch all the impurities. But I will say this, I was at my buddy's house and he had everything in there, impurities and all. And when I say impurities, it's nothing but just like bacon bits. You know what I mean? But that's just the way I do mine. You know what I mean? So I'm gonna go ahead, put some fire back under here. And then what we're getting ready to do is we finna take that andouille and we getting ready to add it right here. Now you want the face to be on the face of your cast iron, right? Cause look, we wanna put a little color. So when I wanna stay on top of it, you see that right there? That's what I'm looking for, right? So you just wanna go ahead and give them a flip. Right, we wanna do the same thing on the other side. So obviously I leave a little bit of the bacon fat in there. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna start with the butter. Listen, bacon fat and butter, that's a whole lot of deliciousness, right? So we'll just start doing that. Now I don't wanna see it do that. That means I'm a little high. The key is we wanna have it low because we're gonna start making a roux. And we don't wanna put no color to our roux, right? Because this is a cheese dip. All right, now that I got everything melted, right? I'm gonna come with my flour. And listen, this is gonna be the key. Right? You know we're making a roux. We want to cook that flour taste out, right? We want it to get all buttery and all of that. But the key is, it's all in my elbow and my wrist in this motion right here. I like to use either a square edge wooden spoon, you know what I mean? Or I like to use a spatula. You know, because if you got any clumps or anything like that, you can go ahead, you know, and just like mash them down, right? So I got it on super low. Don't forget, we're not making a gumbo roux, so we don't need the tins and the dark chocolates and all of that. We just wanna cook this down for about 2 minutes on super, super low, folks. Listen, it's in the title. It's a beer. So we wanna put some in there. We don't wanna be a perpetrator. I'ma just say this. I was taught to make it with a lager, right? But I've been making this so many times and whatever's in the refrigerator, I don't drink the beer. So the number one question you guys gonna have is, ooh, I don't wanna taste no beer. But we gonna cook that out, right? So I'ma just add a little bit to it. You see how it starts to thicken up a little bit? Look at that right there. Just like we making a real roux, like we just added chicken stock, right? Y'all got it now. So just adding a little bit more to it. You know what I mean? I like to add mine in increments, you know what I mean? Then when we're gonna let that cook for about 2 minutes, right? We just need about 1 cup. Okay, so after about a couple of minutes, we getting closer. I guess we approaching closer to 3 minutes, right? Now we're gonna add in our whole milk, right? Okay, so listen, we still in that low heat. I'ma keep stressing that, you know what I mean? Cause look, that's gonna be key. Now look, we want 4 ounces. You know, these come 8. So we're just gonna go ahead, just add it. Kind of like just break it up. Got it on low. It takes a little bit of, you know, takes a little bit cause we want it to all melt, but we let the heat that's in here, we don't want to melt it fast and then you start having issues, right? So now I'm gonna start bringing my cheese into it. Just sprinkling a little bit in at a time, right? We're gonna use this sharp to give us that color and that bite. Right? Look at this right here. I'm gonna let it transform right in front of your eyes, folks. You see how it just disappears? It's not chasing my spatula around, right? And we ain't even put no flavor, you know, no spices and no herbs or nothing like that in here as of yet. So now for the good part. Not that we didn't have the good part already putting it in there. So look, I'm adding some Dijon, some of my spices, which tried to like get away from me. Don't trip, my W sauce, right? Bring this back into the game. And here's where it becomes, hey, look, the magic has already really happened. Right now, this is what we call the polish, you know? So let me get this all incorporated. I'm about to turn this heat off, but now you guys know, when you say a dipping sauce, you want something like a nacho type cheese, this is it right here. Okay, fam, now you see, look, remember what we did in the very beginning? I done probably ate a gang of these, so what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna just take some of these and just sprinkle these over the top. I got some chives, you know what I mean? And then we just go from there. You know, you kind of like do it and display it how you want to. You guys can lay them out with some toothpicks. I got some toothpicks because I usually do game day type things, right? So I got some toothpicks that got the footballs on the top. If I can find a link to them, I'll put it out there for you guys in case you want to get some for yourself. You know, but you got it. I'm not finna bore y'all. You put however much you want to put on here as you would like. Okay, folks, you guys, you know, garnish and make it look like how you want to make it look. But what I'm going to tell you is right now, I'm finna grab one of these toothpicks with these. I grabbed a double. I don't want you guys to say that I'm some type of a pig or nothing like that. But you see that right there? Got that football on there. It's football season. It's Friday. Check it out. We call that Football Fridays. Guess what, folks? Cheers. That right there. It's fire, folks. So listen, if you guys are gonna put something out, you want something to go quick, you put this out and this will hold them off until you bring your main course, you know what I mean, your halftime meal, which I'm gonna have that ready for y'all too, right? So with that being said, listen, try this. Let me know down in the comment section below. Don't forget, if you want a printable recipe, that's smoking and grilling with AB.com. That's WITAB.com, right? Now, if you're new to my channel, you know what to do. Subscribe, like, tell the world. There's a new channel out here that's simplifying these recipes and taking the mystery out of cooking. And with that being said, folks, I'm about to take this board, set this off to the side, and work on my third batch. I'm out. Peace.